Morning, children. Today I'm going to take English for you. I'm your English teacher. My name is Nujeva. Today we are going to learn a new poem. The name of the poem is A House, A Home. It's written by Lorraine M. Kelly. So here in this poem, the poet has explained the difference between a house and a home. He has differentiated it very beautifully. And actually, I'm going to ask a question to you that what is a house? You might have read in your EVS that different types of houses and the materials used for making houses, like, isn't it? So here, the poet asks a question to us. Let me read the poem. Take your textbook. Page number is 15. Okay. Before that, I have told you, I'm going to tell you that the name of your textbook is Honeysuckle. Okay. Honeysuckle. So take your textbook and listen the poem. What is a house? It's brick and stone and wood that's hard. Some window glass and perhaps a yard. It's eaves and chimneys and tile floors and stucco and roof and lots of doors. So here the poet asks a question to us, what's a house? So we have studied in our areas like there are different types of houses, such as paka houses, kacha houses, concrete houses. So here, for these houses, different types of materials used to make. Isn't it? So in this paragraph, or in this stanza, the poet says about the materials used to make a house. Okay, the materials used to make a house. Or what is a house? He himself gives us the answer that it's brick and stone. Okay, it's brick and stone. So here, house is made up of brick and stone. We all know that houses are made up of bricks and stones. And what the next thing? And wood that's hard. Wood that's hard. Here, the houses are made up of wood. And how the wood is, or what kind of wood is that? Hard. Here, is it smooth? Is the wood smooth? No. It's so strong, so hard. It should be strong enough to bear the strength of the house. Okay, so here the poet says that the houses are made up of bricks, stones and wood. Okay, the houses are made up of bricks, stones and of wood. Then here the poet says that some window glass. The houses have window glass. A house has window glass. A house has window which is made up of glass. So here the poet says that a house has window which is made up of glass. We all know that. We all see different types of windows, which is made up of glass, which is made up of wood. So here the poet says that the house has a window which is made up of glass. Then perhaps a yard. What is actually a yard? A yard is an open area in the front or the back of the house. Okay, it's an open place in front of the house or the back of the house. Sometimes some houses have yards in front and in the back. Okay, so so here the poet says that house which is made up of bricks, stones, wood, and it has windows, it has yards, and it has eaves. Eaves, what is actually eaves? The hanging parts out of the walls. So here actually the eaves, actually the edge of a roof, the part of a roof which is coming out of the house like this. Listen. This is a roof, isn't it? This is a roof and some parts, this part and this part, which is coming out of the house. Can you see? It is coming out of the house. Actually, it gives a protection from sunlight, and it also gives us shade, and it also helps to get protection from rain. Like, okay, it gives shade to us. This is called eaves. This part, the edge of the roofs are called eaves. Next to the house has chimneys. Do you know what is chimney? Chimney is it's a pipe which takes smokes from kitchen. Okay, which takes smokes and the smell from fire. Okay, that is called chimney. We all know that our houses, our kitchen has chimneys. Okay, our kitchen has chimneys. So here the poet says that the house is made up of bricks, stones, woods, and it has window, which is made up of glass, and it has yards, and it has eaves and chimneys, and what more? It has tiled floors. Okay, we all know that floors, which is made up of tile here, tiled floors. Then he said that, and stucco. Stucco is a plaster material for coating the walls. It's for decorating, like it gives us a beautiful structure. It gives the house a beautiful structure. That is here called stucco, plaster material. That is called stucco. Then a roof. I told you roof. This is called roof. Okay. Then doors and lots of doors. We know that you all know that we have doors for our bedrooms, kitchens, and our dining rooms, and for our drawing rooms, isn't it? So here in this stanza, the poet says about the materials used for making a house. What are the materials? Here the poet says that the houses are made up of bricks, stones, woods, and what kind of wood? Which is so hard. Then the poet says that it has window, which is made up of glass, and a house has yards, sometimes a yard, and eaves. Is what is eaves? Eaves, the edge of a roof, and it has chimneys, and it has tiled floors, and what next? Stucco. What is it called? Plaster material for coating the walls, and it has roof, and it has a lot of doors. It has a lot of doors. Okay, so here next the poet asks another question to us. What is that? What is a home? Okay, what is a home? Before that, I have told you that this poem, through this poem, the poet tries to differentiate between a house and a home. So actually, what is a home? See, a home doesn't mean a four wall structure. It's a constructed building or four wall structure inside which there live many members, like family members, like father, mother, brothers, sisters, grandparents, uncles. Okay, then they live together, and we share our things with each other, and we love each other, we care for others, isn't it? That is called, that is what is a home. Okay, so here he asks a question to us. What is a home? What is a home? According to him, it's loving and family. Actually, what's a family? A family is it's actually a group of people living together under a roof, living together, and they love each other, they share each other. Okay, so many members are there. If we have a few big family, like grandparents, mother, father, uncles, aunts, cousins, and sisters, so many members will be there, isn't it? So family is a group of people they live together and they share each other and they share the feelings and they share what things and they share, they don't have any selfishness to love each other. Okay, so here it's loving and family and doing for others. What are they doing for others, family? What are they doing for the others? Actually, we all know that a mother. What's your mother doing for you? Your mother is working hard for you and she is waking you up in the morning and she is doing many things for you. She is preparing food for you. She is washing your clothes. She is arranging your room. She is cleaning your room. And actually, she helps you to reach school on time, isn't it? And what's your father doing? Father is working very hard for what? To get you a good education. To give you a good education and to give you a good house. We need a shelter, isn't it? And how we are getting a shelter for us? Because of our father's work, hard work. So here, so that is where the point is that doing for others, our father and our mothers help us to do many things. Not only fathers and mothers, our grandparents help us, our sisters, brothers, everyone helps us to do many things. Next, it's brothers and sisters and fathers and mothers. Here the point says about the relationships. Relationships can be of sister and brothers and relationship it can be of mothers and fathers. And we live together and we love each other and we work for each other and without any selfishness. And next he said that it's unselfish acts. Why it is says that unselfish acts? Actually, the people in a family, they live together and they do many things. And behind their works, there shouldn't be any selfish motive. And is your mother doing things for you for any target? No. No selfish motive is the behind it. Okay. Actually, they are doing selfless things. They are doing selfless acts for us, for getting things for us, and they are helping us without any selfish motive. And next, and kindly shares and showing your loved ones, you are always caring. I told you this many things for you. We are sharing things with others in our family. How we are sharing others, we are sharing responsibilities. And we sisters give things to our younger ones like toys, like sweets, like books, isn't it? And food also sometimes we are sharing with each other. And we care for others, we love them, we care them. In absence of our mother, we help and care our younger ones. And so many things we are doing in our homes. And that is told by the poet here. So you are always caring. So actually, a home. What's a home? A home is a formal structure inhabited by some family members. Some members like father, mother, sisters, brothers, grandparents, and they share each other. They love each other. They share their feelings with others and they care for others. So here a house can be home. A house can be a home. What is a house? House is made up of bricks. Okay, it's only a constructed building. Okay, and how a house can be a home? A home here, a house can be a home if there are some members inside it. Okay, if there are some members living inside a house and sharing their things and loving each other, and if they care for others, and if they love each other, that is called a home. Okay, a house can turn out to be a home by living family members together with self-respect, without any selfish motives, and when respecting each other, by loving each other, and by sharing the feelings of love, sometimes anger, sometimes tensions, we are sharing each other, and if we are sharing our tension with each other, what will happen? We will get some relief, isn't it? We all are doing like that in our homes. If we are tense, what will we do? We will go home and we will tell all these things. We will share our tensed ones, tensed things to our mother or our sisters, and they will help us to get relief. So that is called a home. A house, that is, what's a house? A house which is made up of bricks, stones, wood, and wood, what kind of wood? It is hard, it is not soft, it is strong enough to carry the strength of the, or carry the load of the house. And it has windows, yards, eaves, chimneys, tiled floors, stucco, ropes, and a lot of doors. And what's a home? A home where there are many members, sometimes some members like father, mother, sister, brother, and grandparents, and they live together, they love each other, and that is called a home. Okay, thank you, children.